Hello guys, what's going on? My name is Hiroshi from webstablish.com. Welcome to another video. If this is your first time here, we share software engineering tutorials on this channel. If you want to learn and grow in this area, join us by hitting subscribe button and bell icon. In this tutorial, we are exploring a little bit more on the topic of React state management. Question is, how can you set state correctly in React.js? Which is proper way of mutating state in React.js. We will create a simple counter and increment its value each time when a button is clicked, and we will mutate the state properly. This is our simple React app, and this is the output of this app. Simple text is currently showing as an output for this app, and we have to create a button here. This is my button. I want to show the value of counter here, and I want to click at this button, and I want to see the state changing at this button. Value of the state changing at this button. So let's do this. So we will define the state before the render method, and here will be our constructor. Super props. This will be our state. And state is usually an object. And I will create the state with the property or a key that I am choosing here with the name of counter, and its value is 0. I want to show this value inside this button. So I will use these curly braces. These curly braces are used when you want to execute something in JSX, and this is our JSX in this React app. It's looking like an HTML, but it is not. It is JSX. Okay, so let's show this counter value inside our button. So I will call it like this. This I am using this keyword because this is a class-based component. For class-based component, we always use this keyword almost everywhere. Okay, so this dot state dot state state dot counter. Okay, so this is the value. Now I want to increment this value. So how we mutate the value in this state? We will use an event handler and a function. This dot do increment. So this is our function. Let's write the logic for this function. After this constructor and before this render method, we will use our function doIncrement. So usually we do it like this. Increment the state. Here will be our logic. Increment it. Okay, so button on click this dot do increment. When I will click at this button, this function will be called. Let's test it. So as you can see, I can see the output in the console. Okay, this dot set state will again point to the counter that is right here in this state, and this dot state dot counter plus one. We are incrementing the counter's value and state on each button's click. So here, if I click the button, the value is getting incremented. So this is fine, it is working fine like this. So this is a way to set the state, and it is working fine. It is all right, you can use this method, but there is a better way. You should use the previous state to mutate the state, and it will be like this. So instead of this dot set state, we will do like this. We will use the same method set state, and we will use trev state props arrow function, and then inside we will return counter trev state dot counter plus one. So this time I am not using this dot state. Instead, I am using trev state, and the props here is just to access the props, but we are not using props here. So this method will also work as usual. So if you investigate, let me delete this, and let's get the previous state here. So this was our old value in this state, okay? Let's get the previous state and see what it gives us. So this is the previous state, and inside the render, we access the new state. And here will be the this dot state dot counter. Okay, so this is the old value, and this is the new value. Let's see. So this is our current value. So the old value was 0 and the new value is 1. Again, old value was 1, new value is 2. Again, old value was 2 and the new value is 3. Okay. And in case you just do not want here a static number 1, and if you want to pass an argument and you want to increment this value or mutate this value depending on the argument you are passing, you can do it like this. So on this is our event handler, and this is our function. We will pass a parameter to this function, and let's say I want to increment the counter with the value of 2 each time when button is clicked. I will pass the argument like this, and I will access this value here, do increment. This is the argument. or parameter. I will access this parameter like so. Sent value, let's use sent value. This name can be anything. And here instead of 1, I will access that sent value. And this will work. And now my counter will be incremented each time when button is clicked by value of 2. So 2, 4, 6, 8. It is incrementing each time with the value of 2. Let's give it 10. And now it's 10, and then 20, and then 30. So this is how you can pass the parameters to it. And props is not being used here. If I console log props here, what it will give me, let's see. It is giving me an empty object. So in this case, props is not being used here. You can also omit the props and it will work fine. And you can also omit these and it should work fine. Alright, so this priv state, instead of this dot state, use priv state. Priv state is a reference to the previous state. It is a value of state before the set state was triggered by React. Priv state should be used to mutate state in React.js. So it is the better way of mutating the state in React.js. I hope you liked the video. If we missed anything or you have something to add or share, comment down below. Ask questions related to this topic. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to the channel and hit bell icon to receive channel updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.